Welcome to Music at Noon. How are you all doing? Thank you. Great to see you. So we're going to go for Baroque today. Are you okay with that? Even with inflation, we're going to go for Baroque. Okay, so Baroque and beyond, we've enjoyed their music for 20 years or so, and they've enjoyed being here. So it's a nice two-way street that we have had for many years. And we have a lot of variety of instrumentation, as you can see on your program. And Kathryn Canan, I think you probably was the architect of the program, but of course you're working with all your friends. And so we have Baroque flutes, we have recorders, we have harpsichord, we have cello, bassoon, oboe. And so it's going to be a very varied program. And our composers were friends. But I'm not going to tell you too much about them because they have some stories to tell you. But Bach and Telemann. So please give Baroque and Beyond a nice welcome.
Thank you very much. I'm going, now that you guys, all the sleepers, all you sleepers are awake, we're going to go into a little explanation of this program. As Brad mentioned, Georges Philippe Telemann and Johann Sebastian Bach were contemporaries. Both of them wrote well over 1,000 different pieces of music in their lifetime. And rumor even has it that they interviewed for the same job at one point. So we're going to run with that idea. And you all get to pretend that you are wealthy court owners, and you're going to audition these two composers through their music and find which one you want to be your resident composer. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to find out what kind of music they write for those virtuosos that come to visit your court for solos.
Thank you.
So I would like to add that these two movements are dedicated to my graduate school cello teacher, Antonio Lisi, who passed away quite suddenly 2 weeks ago. He was still very young. He not only did he believe in me as a professional or pre-professional at the time musician, but he taught me that you have to have conviction in every single note you play or there's kind of no point in doing it. Hope you enjoy these.
Thank you.
So I know what you're thinking. That's impossible to make a choice already at this point between Telemann and Bach. So we are in the Baroque period, and we all know that counterpoint, or in other words, how two lines intertwine and work against and with each other, that is king in the Baroque period. So I guess next on our interview process is to find out how both composers write duets that use this counterpoint. I want to give you a little bit so you can listen for it. On Team Telemann over here, we have canonic sonatas. So in other words, the two players are playing the exact same music, just one a measure later, the entire piece, so you can enjoy that. And then meanwhile, on Bach, we have what's called a crab canon, which is in your bulletin, in your program, and it's the same music, but one instrument plays forward, and the other one starts at the end and plays backwards. So, yes, they don't have to read it that way, though, just so you know. So enjoy counterpoint in our interview process.
Thank you.
All right, the pressure's starting to build a little bit here. So what about for ensembles, for trios, in fact? A lot of times, the music at court needed to be to entertain and inspire. So now our two composers are going to continue competing in a bigger trio piece.
Thank you. Thank you.
So as I mentioned, part of the job of a chord composer is also to entertain. So for the last round, we decided to ask our composers to show us something that might be a little bit humorous, might make us laugh, or at least we hope so.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, perhaps it's because he feels like he got bested, or perhaps it's because he has 20 kids waiting for it at home, or perhaps it's because he had too much coffee, but we kind of surmise that perhaps Bach decided he had had enough. Ich habe genug. I've had enough. He withdraws his, as much as he really, really, really wanted the position, he withdraws his application and gives up.
Ich habe genug. My music is my own, and he is mine alone. His comfort he has shown. My Lord, I trust in faith, like Simeon. Oh, now see here.
And with that, Telemann gets the position. But rather than saying hello to his new job, he had a job first. He had to say good night to his beloved canary. And yes, that really is an actual piece of music. Beloved, the canary cantata to a artistically trained bird, I think is what it is called. So we started with Sleepers Awake, and now we will end with My Canary, Good Night.
Thank you.
how sweet the sounds are. You guys have brought us unique sounds, combinations of sounds, humor, seriousness, coffee, ham, and there's nothing in the concert series Music at Noon has like what you give us, and we appreciate that very much. We like variety, and we want more. Thank you. And I'm glad you could be here. It looks to me like CAP Radio is doing their job for us. They are keeping the community informed of live concerts. So even though we're in a different culture now, Bach and Telemann still are appreciated 300 years later. So we're keeping it alive in live music, and we're glad that you're here to share it with us. Please come again. And if you'd like to come next week, you would be probably witnessing some music older than today's music. And we will have duo Viola da Gamba next week, Amy Brodo and Roy Weldon. It'll be another unique program. Hope to see you then. Have a great week. Bye for now.
Tracy.